Man, I don't even know how to describe this to you guys, but pretty much what's going on is Apple is in a very weird situation, and I've been saying this for like so many months now, quite possibly even a year. I'm like, if Apple doesn't get their stuff together, most probably people will really have no reason to upgrade their iPhones or iPads or whatever, and then essentially they're going to just kind of see a downfall in revenue for iPhones. But here's the weird thing, iPhone revenue might have gone down, but the iPad revenue actually went up, and I'll get into that in a second, but pretty much Apple just put out their quarter 2 reports for 2019, and I'm actually reading this from the article from CNET, but don't give them too much clout because they're just regurgitating the info just like I am, so don't give me too much clout either. But in this article, they kind of go on to say that the revenue for iPhones that came out actually went down 17%, okay, to $31.1 billion, which is still a ton of money, but they've seen a 17% drop of people buying iPhones, which is insane, and that is a lot. You know, you might think, oh, it's only 17%, you know, could at least it's not more, but when you're messing with billions and billions of dollars, that is a ton of revenue, and to even seeing go down at all is not a good thing. You know, it should be going up. The fact that it's going down, it should be a huge signal to Apple to really kind of change the things that they're doing. So here's the thing, okay? They have a couple ways of going about this, okay? So, like I said before, with iOS 13, they're going to have to put so much new software, so much new innovation if they want to keep that revenue going up, if they want to change the, I guess, the downfall of the iPhones. And also with this year's iPhones, they're going to have to change something up. And that's why I'm saying they might as well release an iPhone SE 2, but that's for a separate video. Later on this year, they will have to make the new iPhones separate from the older iPhones to make people upgrade. Nobody's going to upgrade to a new iPhone. Nobody's going to buy new iPhones if their older ones can still do the same thing. And that's what I'm saying. That's why I keep posting all these videos, the 6S, the 7 Plus, those phones being amazing phones, because they really are. And Apple needs to start pushing more innovation. And it's not just an Apple problem. I mean, yes, the whole entire phone industry is kind of at a weird place, but there's still a ton of companies like Huawei, for example. They're like increasing in revenue and they're getting bigger and bigger each day. And a person like me, I never thought I would even like use more than like one Huawei phone in my life, but I ended up buying a whole bunch of them because I know there's a demand for them. And it seems like companies like those are kind of pushing more boundaries than Apple is, but you do have to remember that Apple is in quite a few different spots too, because even though their iPhone revenue went down, their iPad revenue went up, which is awesome. And I think that has a lot to do with their new iPad Pros, well, obviously, because those are new devices. But the fact that they kind of changed the design now and they kind of made it look a little bit different really helped increase that kind of perception of iPads now. If they can just go ahead and improve the software within the iPads, I'm sure that revenue will skyrocket too. So what I'm going to try to boil this down to is there's two things that Apple needs to do. One, drop an iPhone SE 2. They need to drop more iPhones in order to increase that revenue. Yes, there's going to be kind of conflict because there's going to be more choices and probably more people are going to get the SE 2 because it's going to be cheaper. But you do have to remember that there's a huge demand for it and there's people who might want to go look elsewhere, maybe for an Android device, because that is a smaller form factor. So you kind of have to keep that in mind. The second thing they need to do is, instead of focusing on the hardware so much, instead of looking at, oh my god, we need 3 cameras in a year, we need a 50,000 mAh battery, which they should increase the hardware and they should increase the battery size and all that stuff. I think one of the most important things they can do is improve the software. You know, with iOS 13, they're going to have to put a bunch of features in it, and I would not be surprised, like I said before, if they kind of put some of the main big features on the newer iPhones and some of the older ones kind of limit those features. Like they've done it in the past, and they're probably going to do it now in the future, but they really need some groundbreaking things, man, like multitasking, picture-in-picture, you know, all these different things that we want. They need to go ahead and throw them in there so then, you know, it gives us more of an incentive to go and upgrade our phones. So ultimately, Apple isn't in a horrible place. Like, yes, they're kind of going up and down here and there, but the iPhone lineup is getting in a really weird spot. And it's kind of interesting. I've seen a lot of people say that Apple is not an iPhone company anymore. And that is a very interesting take on things because, yes, that is kind of true. Their service revenue is going up, their iPad revenue is going up, but their iPhone revenue is going down, which is interesting. And eventually, I'm really curious on what their iPod revenue is. That thing's probably like 0.01%. But I would be kind of curious to see that kind of information. But ultimately, obviously, the iPhones are not going to go bankrupt. They're not going to stop developing them or anything. But it is kind of an interesting thing. And, you know, ultimately, it could mean that the iPhones are in trouble. It's hard to say at this point. But, man, it's a really weird situation that Apple is in. You know, ultimately, we just need new innovation, more innovation at that. So I guess we'll see what happens with Apple in the future. But that is pretty much it. If you guys have any questions or anything, leave it down in the comment section below. Hit that like button. That'll mean so much. But definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count. So it means so much if you guys could hit that. Also, check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel, all those links are linked down below. I'd really appreciate it if you guys could check it out. But more importantly than everything else, I'll love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.